baby on board. Kalani and Aisulu got some unexpected pregnancy news that changed everything for them during the Sunday, December 16, episode of 90 Day Fiancé. The news couldn't have come at a worse time, and Kalani was not excited about it. Catch up on what you might have missed during this week's episode with our recap. Kalani and Aisulu are pregnant and unhappy. Kalani and Aisulu have had a lot on their plate, and this week they learn some major news that changes everything. They are expecting a second child. "It's not good timing right now," Kalani said. "I feel like I'm not even as good of a mom as I should be now, and now I'm going to have another baby to take myself away from my baby even more. I just feel even more overwhelmed than I already did, and I'm so sick of disappointing my family." Aisulu was excited, which made Kalani worry that he was only wanting another baby to make her have to marry him. "I did not come here for just make another baby and go away," Aisulu said. "I think that we work together and move forward." Kalani felt better after discussing things with Aisulu. However, she made the decision to not tell anyone in her family besides her mom, which will no doubt cause more problems down the road. Colt shopped for Larissa's one-way ticket home. Colt decided he was done with Larissa after she blew up on his entire family and started looking online for a plane ticket for her to go home. "I can't live with someone unreasonable like that," Colt said. "If she's unhappy with me, she has to go." Larissa understood the gravity of the situation and apologized for overreacting. She even promised not to do it again, but that didn't last long. When the couple was on a double date with Colt's friends, Larissa snapped at him for not complimenting her after she did her makeup for 2 hours. "It's always about you," Colt screamed at her. "You're bat-tee crazy." He ended up giving her a bunch of compliments to spare himself from the embarrassment in front of his friends, and the two ended the evening on good terms. We'll have to wait and see how long it will be until their next argument. Eric's ex confronted Lita. There was a lot of tension after Lita kicked Eric's daughter out. Eric felt like he was put in a tough situation but decided to side with Lita because if he didn't, she'd leave him. "Being a father to me is the most important thing in the world, so to kick Tasha out is absolutely a horrible decision that someone has to make," Eric cried. "We have to make tough choices. Sometimes that tough choice doesn't sit well." Eric's ex Tanya chose to intervene calmly once the situation involved her kids and talked to Lita privately. She said the kids hoped that Eric and Lita would break up and had no interest coming to the wedding. Lita couldn't have cared less. "The most important thing in my life is Eric and my son," Lita said. "Who cares about the others?" Fernanda might be headed back to Mexico. Fernanda has been struggling being cooped up alone in the house. This week, John met with a friend after work for a drink, but Fernanda texted him so much he had to leave. "He doesn't understand how much I need him here. He doesn't understand that I'm alone," Fernanda said. "I don't have nothing." John was upset because he thought he gave up so much for Fernanda and provided her everything, and he should be able to meet a friend for an hour after work. However, Fernanda was so upset she started packing her bags. "I just want to come back to my home with my mom. With my friends," Fernanda said. "I feel like I don't belong here." Ashley's friend bombarded their home. Ashley's old friend Natalie decided it would be a good idea to show up at her house, bang on the door and scream at her for marrying Jay. "I'm seriously over her being so overdramatic about everything," Ashley said. Natalie, who thinks Jay is a cheater, would not leave, saying that Ashley deserved better. Meanwhile, Jay suggested that Ashley call the cops to get Natalie to leave. "It wasn't my idea to cut Natalie out for good," Jay said about Ashley's decision to end the friendship. "Natalie is giving her so much reason not to be friends with her anymore." Steven wanted to take his baby away from Olga. Olga was nervous this week because her baby was getting his American passport, and she has not heard anything about her K-1 fiancé visa. She worried that Steven was only focusing on the baby's papers because they were fighting so much and he didn't want to be with her. "I worried about if my K-1 visa is not approved, he thinks he can take the baby to America," Olga said. "It will destroy me. I think it will be the end of my world." Stephen got the baby his passport and immediately mentioned bringing the baby to the States without his fiancé, and Olga lost it. This situation was left unresolved, so hopefully Olga somehow gets her visa in time.